Alright, so we're going to do another parts video here. We're going to do a more in-depth, full walk around of the full collection of everything that is for sale. This is all me and my dad's stuff. This is anything that you see indoors here. Pretty much everything in here is listed on eBay for sale. Anything that you see, almost, there's probably a few things that aren't, but anything you see would be for sale online, or I'll sell it to you direct. I'll leave a link to another video I did probably about a week ago, and you can look at more information there. But there's going to be a little bit of a quicker run through. So real quick, long story short, if you need something, let me know. I'll have it in the description, but this is my email, RyanBarsnessYT@gmail.com. What I want you to do, if you do need something, is this would help me a lot. Obviously, include your name, your phone number, what are you looking for, and where are you located. And another thing that helps a lot is if you have a set budget. Obviously, I know everybody wants to get the best deal possible. I understand that, and I know that. But there are certain times, like if you're looking for, I'll use this as an example, this wood grain steering wheel, there's not a crack, there's not a flaw in it really, it's a little bit dirty. If you're looking for something like that, and your budget is only $100, I'm sorry, I can't help you. And same thing with, I mean, there's all kinds of different stuff. And then likewise, use this as an example again, if you're looking for a 70, 71, 72, whatever, wood grain Challenger steering wheel, and you have a wide budget, you could get one like this, which would be reasonably priced, or you can get this one, which is practically restored. So that's what the budget side of things really, really helps me with. Because here's the other thing, if I don't have it, I will, in this notebook or whatever, I'll write down what you wrote in the email, your name, your phone number, what you're looking for, your location, and if you can include it, your budget, and if I don't have it, I'll send it to guys I know that might have it. So I'm very willing and very happy to help people find stuff, even if I myself cannot provide it. So, moving on, let's look at some other stuff here. Got everything from Hemi valve covers to this whole shelf is mostly dash-related parts. The top shelf is all small chrome trim and emblems and such. This whole area here is all brand new reproduction parts, CUDA exhaust tips, pedal pads, all kinds of little stuff like that. I do excuse the mess. We're really trying to kind of get rid of a lot of stuff and clean up. And there's 69 Coronet tail panels up there, RT panels. There's 66 Belvedere tail panel, all kinds of stuff. And we will go outside and look at some cars and stuff too. And I'll do more full in-depth videos on cars, but at least get a little bit of a glimpse for you guys. 71 Challenger taillights, header panel for a 73 Satellite, header panel for a 69 Barracuda, small block valve covers that have been repainted, all kinds of stuff like that. Then moving over here, some big block valve covers, headlight bezel for A-body, more A-body stuff. Got a whole entire thing of nothing but these steering column trim covers of all different years. A couple of grills, 70 GTX or Sport Satellite only, because it's got the hexagon, kind of like a honeycomb. Same thing here. And I do have stuff in all different conditions, not just like super nice stuff. There is some lightly damaged stuff for people that are creative and can do a little plastic welding or can fill in some gaps where the condition doesn't quite add up. So we have a lot of stuff, and this is not by any means everything. Like here's a cluster bezel up there for a 71. This whole thing is basically all ashtrays and then some other dash parts. This I just completely reorganized. Is all 68 through 70 dash parts. All A-body stuff there. Mostly E-body stuff there. There's a Polara part there. quarter extensions, taillight extension, housings, all that stuff. So there's a lot of stuff here, and I'm definitely willing to give people a deal on stuff, especially if you get more than one item. I save a lot of money in shipping when I do that. And as you know, shipping is very expensive these days with fuel prices and all that other stuff, not to get into that long mess. But I mean, everything from A-body consoles to window trim for 71 through 4 B-body to... There's a 66 Charger headlight bezels, there's a Barracuda part, there's all kinds of stuff. There's 67 B-body bezels, there's 65 Coronet pair of bezels, there's a dog dish hubcaps, a couple of carburetors, 67 satellite rear finish panel, not really a finish panel, but a back seat panel, trim panel, and there's some other modern RAM parts. We don't really get into that stuff, but we have parted a few of them out, so that's why you see some of that stuff. But yeah, that's pretty much it for upstairs. I want to bring you guys downstairs quick, and we'll go outside after that. Got some more stuff down here. This is kind of some overstock, overflow, bunch of headlight bezels, random kind of miscellaneous stuff. And none of this stuff down here is actually listed online. Another piece of information, you know, I want to sell stuff reasonably, and if somebody had the cash to do so, I would sell the entire like upstairs online eBay lot. There's $145,000 worth of parts upstairs. I'd sell it for significantly less if somebody was a kind of a big player and had a lot of money to do something like that, but I doubt that. A couple of these parts are actually listed online as well, but a bunch of overstock stuff, some dash parts for e-body, more e-body stuff, more e-body non-rally stuff, 69 satellite headlight bezels, Roadrunner headlight bezels, let's see what else, bunch of big block valve covers. These are all big block valve covers. There's a few small blocks as well. There's a bunch of marker lights. There's some turn signal lenses for like a 68 Coronet, 69 Coronet. Let's see, there's some trim rings. There's a bunch of CUDA taillights. I got more of those outside too. Some 71 Challenger tail panel parts, some stuff like that. So yeah, that's kind of it for inside. There's not a whole lot of stuff in here, but... let's go outside and look at some parts, and let's show you guys some cars. Bunch more stuff outside. I got to get all this stuff taken somewhere and put a lot of it away. I just don't have the space for it. Entire bracket assembly and shifter assemblies for slapsticks and for the earlier, like 66 through 70 style shifters. There's a couple of 4-speed parts over there. I don't have a lot of 4-speed stuff. I have very little 4-speed stuff, and I have almost no Hemi stuff. By all means, if you want to send me an email and you're looking for that kind of stuff, I can pass your information on. Once again, if you can format an email, name, phone number, what you're looking for. Your location is also good for getting shipping rates and for a lot of other reasons. And budget really, really helps. I highly, highly suggest because... And just because you say you have a $200 budget for a part does not mean we're going to charge you $200 for the part. Maybe I find you one that's good for $150 or so. So, moving over here, that's actually sold, but there's A-body bench seats, a lot of A-body bench seats. There's a pair of 70 Challenger 6-way adjustable seats. Those are pretty good. There's a 65 Belvedere fender, probably only a parts fender. It's got some rust. Here's some like 64, 65, 66 Barracuda seat parts. There's some intakes. There's a bunch of alternators. There's a bunch of like brake parts, all kinds of stuff. Anything on this trailer would be really reasonably priced. Problem is it's hard to ship anything that's on this trailer because they're heavy, heavy parts. And if you don't know, most shipping places add an additional $25 surcharge to any item that gets shipped that's over 50 pounds. So keep that in mind. But yeah, a lot of stuff in here. There's some acorn style center caps. So Real quick, we're gonna move on to a car here. I'm gonna do a full in-depth video probably tomorrow on this car. You've seen it in the background, some of my other videos, and if you want to look at some of my other videos, please consider liking, subscribing, all that stuff. That really helps out a lot. We're getting close to 800 subscribers, and we're well on our way to 1,000, so let's keep that going. This is a 68 Coronet RT. This is a real deal RT. Bucket seat, console, factory tack car. It is pretty rusty in the back. It needs rear frame rails, needs quarters, trunk pan, trunk extension, the whole deal. But I have all the metal to do it. Every bit. I've got brand new quarters, 68 quarters, may I add, and this is all AMD metal. 68 quarters with the correct marker white hole and everything in it. I've got the complete full one-piece trunk pan. I've got the full rear frame rails. I've got so much stuff to do this car and do it right. The only other part that's a problem is it does have a hole in the one of the front frame rails, and the inner fenders have been cut for fender well headers, so that will need to be addressed. But I do have access to the entire front clip structurally, and the inner fenders and everything off of a different 68 through 70B body. They're all the same. So, and this is a factory tack car and everything, like I said. So, this car with all the metal and everything, and it comes with a 1968 HP 440 and automatic transmission. It is not the original, but it's as close as you can get. This one's going to be mid-upper teens for the car like this. Other stuff in the background, none of this is for sale. Please do not ask. So, we're going to move around into kind of the backyard, side yard area, and we'll show you more cars and more parts there. All right, we're in a different part of the yard. We got some 1973 Satellites here. This one is purely a parts car, very rusty car, but it has a complete rally dash assembly and a lot of other parts. It's got, you know, the whole disc brake setup. It's got a lot of small stuff, a lot of stuff you can cut off, and a lot of miscellaneous parts. Very good parts car still, but as far as it being a car, it's not really a car anymore. This car, as you can see, the door was pushed in, but and the quarter has a little dent, but I have a amazing mint condition door for it. You can pop that quarter out fairly easily. This is as close to rust-free as you can find. It says it's rust-free as far as I've found so far. This car is out of Texas, and it's just a 318 automatic, but you can fix that 318 automatic situation pretty easily with that car over there. That is a running 400 big block car, just two barrel, but it runs good. And it's got the big block K member. You can take the whole big block K member out of this car and the hood if you wanted to, and put it into the Texas car, and it would make a heck of an assembly. And beyond that, I do have a pretty much mint condition 1973 Roadrunner hood for this car. So, primarily interested in selling the Texas car and the 400 big block car together. And this could go with a very reasonably priced in addition to that if desired. And that is a rally dash as well. Most of the gauges work on it, even the gas gauge works on it, if I remember correctly. So, for the package here, right around $5,500, our best offer. This has a clean, clear title. So, definitely keep that in consideration if you know anybody looking for a relatively easy project. And these 73s, they're really coming around as far as price and value-wise. This car, this is a 1966 Belvedere 2. This is the parts car for my 66 Belvedere 2, the cheap thrill drag car. I'm taking that door and the other fender off of that side, and I'm using it on my car. And the trunk lid. And I'm putting my lesser condition parts back on it, and this will be a complete titled car. It will have no engine or transmission, and it will not have any of the parts that are in it, other than whatever parts are needed to complete it. This car is rusty in the back end. but it does have a really nice roof. The inner fenders are pretty bad, right by the shock towers are pretty rusty. But it does have a good roof. It appears to have good rockers. It appears to have like this whole back behind the window area down over here seems pretty good. The trunk gutters are good. It's a heck of a parts car. You know, if somebody wants to take it as a roller with my door and my fender put back on it, you know, if somebody wants to give me $1,500 for it, clear title, take it away. So, anyways, moving on. TA Challenger is sold. Please don't ask. This 72 Charger is potentially going with the 72 Roadrunner. The 72 Roadrunner is sold. Please don't ask. This big block Challenger. Somebody was cutting this part for a drag car and needs pretty much everything, but it's a clear title 383 two barrel car. Needs a lot of work. Needs everything. But it has a good roof and some other part. Well, the roof is mostly good. It has a couple little spots on it, but the roof structure, a lot of other stuff like that is good on the car. Somebody wants to give me $2,500. Clean title, it's yours. Like I said, Roadrunner is sold. This car is going away. That will not be available. This thing's a piece of junk, anyways. But 1968 Barracuda convertible. Somebody wanted to come take this whole thing away, they could. You know, it'd be a few $100. You know, it's got the convertible top assembly. It's got a little bit of rust in the top assembly, but it's mostly good. It's got the console. It's got the four-shift steering column. It's got a bucket seat. I have the other bucket seat for it. But this car is purely a parts car. There is no saving this. Somebody wants to take this away for $400 or $500, maybe a little less or something. I don't have a title for it. Sold as is. Somebody's interested, let me know. Once again, there's my email, name, phone number. What are you looking for? Your location, and what's your budget? This other yellow 70 Challenger is sold. Please don't ask. 67 Monaco 500. I will very, very likely be parting this car out. If somebody sees something they need, let me know. It's a power bucket seat car. The console is not going to be sold. The dash is really nice overall. I don't know if anybody needs a dash. It's power bucket seats. It's got a tilt and telescoping steering wheel. If you go way back in my videos, I have a full in-depth video on this car. I think the title of it was called the High Performance C-Body. This has a 1967 HP 440 and automatic in it that are not likely to be sold. So that's the story on that. But yeah, we'll show you a couple other things and we'll wrap this video up. This car is actually a really, really, really nice car. 1971 Satellite, just a Satellite Sebring. No title. I don't have a title. I'm not going to get a title. I did legitimately purchase it. I think I have a bill of sale from it and everything. But no, I do not have a title for this car. I am keeping the trunk lid, the doors, the fenders. I'm keeping pretty much all the sheet metal off of it for my own personal car. But the bones of this car are perfect. The frame rails are amazing. The trunk pan has paint on it still. The floor pan, I don't think there's a hole in it. The roof is amazing. The inner fenders, I think there's just a little bit of rust by the hood hinges. I will do a full in-depth video on this. This will be sold no title, as a shell, no trunk lid, no doors, no fenders, no bumpers, none of that. It'll be sold as a rolling shell, with or without the 400 big block that's in it. It has like a 76 400 big block in it. It's just a long block. I'm sure it's seized up. It's been sitting open for I don't know how many years. And then this has a Roadrunner hood on it that could be negotiated for as well. This will probably go $2,500, you know, somewhere around there, plus or minus. Same thing's happening to this 71 Satellite. I got to get a weed eater and weed eater all around this and actually do full in-depth videos. But the front area is really nice. Firewall is nice. The floors are bad. The trunk has been cut out. I'm keeping the doors off of it because they're decent, and I'm keeping the trunk lid off of it because they're decent. But other than that, it will be sold the same way as this one is. No title. I don't have a title. I'm not getting a title. And if you want to get a title, I know people that can help you out with that. Otherwise, you can go through various different services. If you're interested in this one will probably be a little over $1,000, $1,1500, depending on how clean it is once I get it cleaned up a little bit. So we're gonna look at a couple other things inside quick, and we'll go from there. All right, now I know you guys aren't gonna be able to see this very well, but that's a 1971 Challenger. I cut the floor out of it because the floor pan was rusted. I have the brand new floor pan and the rear seat, not rear seat pan, the rear stepwells that the passenger's feet rest in. This has very little rust. I can't really get to the car right now. I will do a full in-depth. This may be for sale, maybe for sale in a few different ways. I would sell it as it is with the metal that I have, of course. Or I would finish it for somebody. We really are trying to convert into doing cars more. So I could do a full in-depth video on that. This would be mid-low teens as it is, because it's a very solid car. A real 71 Challenger. It was a 318 four-speed car, kind of an oddball. But we'll leave it at that for now. We'll just go back outside quick and we'll wrap this video up. Right, so that'll be it. I'll just kind of leave it at that. I know this is going to be kind of a long video, but had a lot of things I was going through. So I'm going to be doing in-depth videos on pretty much all the cars that you see, other than, maybe a couple of them. But once again, if you need to contact me, email me your name, your phone number, what you're looking for, your location, and your budget helps a lot. Another thing I will say, I know where a lot of cars are. If you're looking for a project car, I can help you. And your location is very important in that, because I'm in Minnesota. We're in South Central Minnesota. And I know of cars in Wisconsin, Iowa, South Dakota. I mean, I know of them all over. I know of them in Minnesota. I do pretty much everything in the upper Midwest. So if you are looking for stuff, let me know. I'll do my very best to help you. I'm going to be writing a bunch of people's names and what they're looking for in this notebook and sending it to anybody I know that can help. So definitely please consider liking and subscribing. I'm going to be going back to more car-related stuff soon. Definitely going to be getting back working on the project cars. So definitely check that out if you haven't already. And I'll leave it at that, and I'll see you guys in the next video.